without water along the sun so grown. We crossed over borders.
Welcome back to the Grand Lady, everyone. If you're new here, we're sharing the real life journey behind renovating an abandoned 110 plus year old house. This week we're tackling the decision about what can be done with those wood floors that were damaged after the incompetent roofers flooded our whole house. There's also a surprise in the middle we hope you enjoy. Thanks for coming to see us. Let's get rolling!
I'm gonna make you the star of the show here.
It's all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. I did it all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. Nights without sleeping, 'cause you fear the night. And days without eating, 'cause it ain't enough for two.
I'm really trying to take my rose-colored glasses off for a bit to really take a critical look at the condition of these floors. And I can show you what I'm looking at. These are bowed up right here, so that's this length. These have too much damage to salvage. This area over here is bowed up. And this area as well. So this area right here looks... we have 3 square feet right here. That's good. When you get to over here, it starts to be bowed with water damage. And then this starts to look okay right in here. These are connected to these, so we'd have short little lengths. Over here, we start to see some damage. Okay, right here. So it's just scattered areas. This is not salvageable. This is water bowed, which I hadn't really recognized before. Oh, goodness. I don't know, peoples. What do you think? Let's go get jamming. Have another discussion now that we've looked at it a little closer.
Still trying to deny it.
We are.
I've been lying here for too long. I don't know what else to do. I wanna get away from every little thing just to try to make it through. I've been
thinking about my options.
How would you like to proceed?
I think in order to avoid any more mold and mildew, is there a point of no return in a house?
Probably, but that's a way off.
Well, I'd like to not even be close to that.
Yeah. Fortunately, with the cold weather, the mold growth is slowed way down.
Right.
We have that,
but it's also not drying.
That's right. It's like refrigerator mold now.
It's refrigerator mold.
Here's what I think.
All right. Let me sit down.
You sit on the railing.
Maybe you shouldn't sit on the railing. Oh, no. What do you think about this floor situation, Jim?
I think the next thing we need to do is take the oak flooring up down to the subfloor. Like the remediation of reports in August that needed to be done immediately. Get our antique furnace fired up in the basement so that we have a little bit of heat in here to dry it out. We should have our insulating and house wrap, another guy lined up to do it. January 1st and onward, that'll put a wrap around the house so we have a little bit of an insulating cocoon around this part. And with the antique furnace firing full time in the basement, we should have enough convective heat rise up through here and out through the unsealed attic to gradually dry the house out.
Okay, well, it's breaking my heart, but I think we're deciding to not salvage the floors. And pull them up to just start getting this place dried out. Continue on with the work plan, which is the furnace, plumbing, electrical, drywall. I don't want to do it. But what? So it's just not salvageable, I think is what I'm trying to finally put together in my head. It's just not salvageable, even if you pull it up carefully. It's too far gone.
Yeah.
Did you know that already?
Pretty much.
You've just been waiting for me. I'm sorry it took me so long, but oh my gosh, I wanted to save these floors so bad.
That's what we were planning on to begin with. Refinish these. Like, this floor wouldn't have had to have any repair work done on it.
No, but now it's all water damaged.
Yeah,
and it's moldy underneath it. And it's... Okay. Well, I guess I just was hoping there was something. There was some... Even if we had to do the extra work, maybe ask for extra time and somehow be able to manage it, but I just don't. It's now that I've realized that it's just not salvageable because of the damage, then I'm okay. I mean, we can't leave it. It's gone. She's lost her floors. So we will just do the best we can for her from now on and just get them up so she can dry. And nothing else deteriorates from it, and we will give her some beautiful, beautiful, new, strong, resilient, well cared for floors, and she will shine like the beauty she was. Just move ahead that way. I can do that. As long as I feel like it's worth something, will be better for her in the end. Poor lady. This poor lady. She didn't get torn down, but boy, she's had a rough go of it. Thanks for letting me take my convoluted journey to reality.
It was a good dream to hold on to. I liked it.
Me too. Well, I'm ready to get started. Are you?
Go and work angry?
Yep. Yep. Work off some of this frustration. Heartbreak. You with me?
Yep.
Oh. I love you.
VP of the company. We got haircuts. I told him he could stop by and take a look at the project.
Well, this is my last name, dude.
How are you? You too. No worries. We're all vaccinated. You're good. The mask. So you were able to get everything dried out pretty good?
Oh, no. Not yet.
No.
We just got it finally open. One side of... Come on here. One side of each shot.
You're tall and strong, you're one of a kind. Way too good to be left behind. Or we're thrilled we found you to make you our home. The grand lady. You sagged and you creaked, but weathered the storm. We're here to help you. You've got good form, but you won't give up. You're as tough as hell. The grand lady. If these walls could talk, the stories they tell, the treasures left behind we will never sell. You're a gift to us for all to see. The grand lady. You're a beauty on the outside, inside too. You're changing every day with the things that we do. You are who you are, and always will be. The grand lady.
Sure, I'm worried a little bit. We'll figure it out.
Well, I'm worried too, but...
A deluge of water inside.
We also got underneath this central beam. That's some of our lemonade from this...
You're tall and strong, you're one of a kind. Way too good to be left behind. Or we're thrilled we found you to make you our home. The grand lady. You sagged and you creaked, but weathered the storm. We're here to help you, you've got good form. You won't give up, you're as tough as hell. The grand lady. If these walls could talk, the stories they tell, the treasures left behind we will never sell. You're a gift to us for all to see. A grand lady, you're a beauty on the outside, inside too. You're changing every day with the things that we do. You are who you are, and always will be.
Absolutely, anytime. Give me a call, let me know.
First one to 10 nails wins.
Oh, you win already.
Youth!
Youth!
the youth.
Welcome back to Hammer Wars. I'm Bert Bertson, sitting here with my longtime colleague Tom Thompson. What do you say we do a little post-game analysis, Tom, as our winning player does some cool-down pulls and we can really see her form?
Well, it's good to be here with you on this fine winter day in Syracuse, Bert. And oh, you have a good idea there. You know, it's rare we get to see such a masterful skills this close up. Now, if you take a look right now, she's using a classic two-handed bend-over pose we call here in the nailing world the bender-over, coined originally by lovely Miss Betty White. We tip our hammers to you, Betty. You will be sorely missed.
Yes, this is a classic right out of the Betty White handbook. But as you've heard from many a puller, this pose, although does allow for quick maneuvers, it takes its toll on energy consumption and isn't usually maintained throughout the whole pulling event. Let's watch closely and see what move she transitions into.
Oh, I see she's mixed it up in an unusual way with some wonderful one-handed reverse bend-overs. You can't see this just anywhere, Bert.
Looks like she's taking some time to stretch her bender. A good strategy for longer events.
I hear she's studied under Tom Vila.
Yes, as we expected, she's transitioned into a one. Nope, make that a two-knee backacre. Yes, also a classic in this sport. She looks as if she's really focusing on her back aching form, not brushing it.
Well, it appears as if she's using a new technique of hammerhead sweep to hone in on her targets. Interesting. You'll notice other nail pullers employ a second tool to hone in, much like the puller behind her. This hammerhead technique is really an advanced method, allowing the efficiency of just one tool. Quite remarkable, I'd say, wouldn't you, Bert?
Oh, tremendous. How effortlessly she moves from the two-knee backacre to the one-handed as well as the two-handed praying this is over move. Her skill level is just beyond belief here.
Indeed, she appears to be in peak nail puller form. Oh, and look, she's transitioned back into a bender over, unprecedented at this point in the day. Oh, and wait a minute, is that a sumo? Back into a bender over, then onto a one-knee croucher? I never thought I'd see that move again after the sudden retirement of Stella Stanley. These two have a remarkably similar yet unique approach to nail pulling. I must say it's quite an honor to have seen both of them in competition in my lifetime.
Oh, it looks like she's left the playing floor. Is everything... Oh, well, now we really are seeing the commitment this athlete has to the sport. Keeping the playing floor clean and safe for not only herself, but for her fellow athletes as well.
What a day it's been, Bert. What a day.
Yes, Tom, it's been quite a day here at Hammer Wars. Well, thank you for watching Hammer Wars today here on your local Syracuse network. I'm your host, Bert Bertson, and Tom Tomlinson here to help you through the winter days of upstate New York. Stay tuned for the semifinals of Staple Gun Shooting and the latest cooking show from our sponsor, Would You Eat That? Have a good evening!